phrase, like, put off the old man, put on the new man, right? It's to die to this, but come alive to Christ. And what Caleb was doing is he was going, I'm going to wage war on this. I'm going to burn bridges to my feeding grounds. But I've got to take all of this desire that I have, all this, take all of my affection and all of my attention and have it terminate where it belongs, which is with my wife and my relationship with God, who loved me and gave himself up for me so I could be forgiven and have another opportunity to live right. And he began taking all the fuel he could get his hands on, throwing it on that fire, his time, his energy, his resources, and stoking it up as big as he could so that he was warmed and captivated and dazzled by that fire, not the one over here that was going to burn his life out. Caleb burned the bridges to his feeding grounds, and then he replaced the altar where his lust was worshipped with a bouquet of roses for his wife and a note that said, I love you more. You see that two-part strategy? You've got to lean into your wife. You've got to lean into your husband. And as you get your heart right, that brings life into the whole garden. Be so dazzled with the love of God demonstrated for you at the cross that it empowers you to love your spouse more than your secret sin. Will you pray with me? Father, we thank you for giving us an afternoon free of distractions. Lord, please open our ears so that we can hear truth. Open our eyes so that we can see honestly. Help us to look into the mirror today and to look at the gift that you've given us, our spouse. Show us, Lord. Speak to us. Your servants are listening. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.